Hi everyone, welcome back to DIY with Danica. For today's tutorial, I'll be sharing with you how you can take a small budget of $20 and use that to take your home decor from light and breezy for summer to warm and cozy for the fall by making just a few subtle changes that will have a huge impact on your overall look without making a huge dent in your wallet. You might be wondering, how is she going to take that living room, which is decidedly laid back, beachy, summery, and get it decorated for fall for less than $20? Well, I'm glad you asked. I went to the Dollar Tree and there I got so many things, I feel like a kid on Christmas. I can't wait to show you what I got for less than $20. Are you ready? Okay. So, starting off, I got this wreath. A dollar, everything's gonna be a dollar, so I'll spare you that. I got a wreath, two mason jars, these really cute bows that bring in some oranges and some browns. I got some ribbon, some wire ribbon, and it's a nice rust orange color. I got another set of ribbon that's a plaid, a thinner ribbon to tie some bows. I got this mesh, which has some nice cream and gold running through it. I got a picture frame so that I can take the picture that I currently have in a silver frame and warm it up. Now it's got a gold frame. I got this really cute ceramic pumpkin, and it's white and cream, which goes with my look. I found this. Not sure what I'm gonna do with this yet, but it is gonna work its way into my design plan. I got this little wisp that has some pine cones and other things that I plan to put on that wreath. I got a orange or burnt orange pumpkin, which I plan to coat in this gorgeous glitter. Like, this glitter is so perfect for fall. It has some dark brown, some rust orange, gold. It's gorgeous. And I got these fall leaves, individual fall leaves. I got these words. They're silver. They say things like thankful and welcome. Might say blessed, I haven't taken them out, but they say things. I got some nautical rope, kind of got a burlap kind of feel, rustic feel. I picked up this decoupage glue, which is gonna help me attach that glitter to different things to bring some sparkle to the room. And last but not least, because I want my decor to not only be pleasing to the eye, I also want it to be pleasing to the other senses, I picked up this Sure Scent pumpkin smell. So once it's all put together, not only will it look like fall, it'll smell like fall too. Our first project is going to be to transform this plain $1 wreath into something more suitable for the season. So to start this project, I am going to be taking my glue gun and attaching my mesh, my gold infused mesh, and wrap it around the wreath until the wreath is completely covered. Okay, so it's already looking very lovely. Next, I want to attach these flowers. Attach these flowers. Mm-hmm. to use this rope to wrap around the bottom. Cover up these stems. So it's looking pretty good. So I want to attach this word thankful to the center of my wreath. However, I want to give it some color. So I'm going to give it a light sanding with some sandpaper and then add my decoupage glue and the orange glitter, I think, so that it will stand out a bit more on the wreath. Okay, so again, I have my thankful words. I'm going to sand them with some sandpaper. If you don't have sandpaper, then you can use an old emery board because your objective is simply to get that sheen off of it. It doesn't have to be a hard sanding, just enough so that the glue and the glitter will attach. Now I'm going to take my Mod Podge glue finisher, my Mod Podge, and use a paintbrush and glue it on, paint it on. Take my glitter. Okay, I'm going to set this aside and let it dry. While my glittery thankful dries, I am going to be taking my wreath that I've been working on, and I am going to attach this last little bit of rope at the top to hang it. And I think that is where my ribbon is going to come in. Thank you.
here we have our finished product. Now, you could go to the store and buy yourself a wreath. That probably would cost you anywhere from $10 to $20, but you wouldn't get as much joy and pleasure from telling people who admire your wreath that you made it yourself.
My next project is going to be to take this pumpkin and spice it up a little bit by putting my decoupage glue on it and covering it with some glitter so that it has a bit of a sparkle when I put it on the mantle. For my next project, I'm going to take this plain frame that has a little bit of gold on it and attach some of my fall leaves to it. My next project is going to be to transform these plain mason jars into nice votive candle holders. I'll be doing that by taking this plaid ribbon, wire ribbon, and attaching it around the center of the jar, and then taking this other ribbon and attaching it to the lid and making a nice bow. So as we can see, we're already transforming. Because this is going to be holding a votive candle, and you can choose to use the real ones or the fake ones, but in case you're gonna have a real one in there, you wanna take this top piece out of the lid and just screw the top back on, so that when you do put a candle in there, the flame doesn't catch this part on fire. Okay, so now I'm going to be taking this ribbon and attaching it to the top. Project is figure out what I want to do with this. I think this one might actually just go on the front door. We'll have the sense of the eye, we'll have the sense of the smell from the pumpkin scent, and we'll have the jingle of the bells as someone enters the front door. Perfect. I think this ceramic piece is gonna be a standalone type piece. I don't think I really need to do anything to this one. But what I would like to do is to take my candles, which are currently on the mantle, and to zhuzh them up a bit with some of this nice sparkly wire pumpkin ribbon. So that's gonna be my next project. What I like best about the project that I did with the candles is that it's temporary. So it looks nice, it's gonna be great for fall, but I can take it off when it's time for Christmas and summer, spring. I'm not committed to these looks. They're not set in stone.
And here we see the mantle all decked out for fall. And again, this costs less than $20.
Thank you guys for watching. If you have any questions about how I transformed my living room from summer to fall with a budget of $20, then please leave them in the comments section. And remember, if I can do this, you can do this.